I mean, that is the nightmare. I mean, they don't agree to do it, but I don't know how you get away with it.
Well, you were just saying you'd hate it.
Well, I would hate it.
You don't know what position you'd be sleeping.
Well, I know, because I always got one leg over the duvet with my giant possum hanging out the bed. I do not need that on screen.
There's something that happens, doesn't it? I don't know how, but we all do. How do you sleep, Philip? Do you do that thing with the duvet? Because you start with the duvet on top, and then soon it sort of comes out a bit.
Yeah, I know, I did that.
And then there's sort of the bottom in the air situation.
Cold room, so.
Yeah, cold room, window open.
More and more and more becomes out as the...
somebody doesn't like...
Yeah, well, I'll let me tell you what's happened this series. So we've made it all celebrities because I think people prefer to see celebrities in distress.
Yeah.
So we have Judge Rob Rinder, who liked the experience the least by some distance. He was in such a deep sleep, we could have stared at him all night.
Really?
He had had like a scotch and God knows what. He was absolutely out for the count.
Oh.
So we actually sort of had to wake. It took a while to get him up.
Really?
And then he just lost his mind. Unmissable television. Craig Revel Horwood, I woke up for the Christmas Midnight Game Show twice. I frightened him twice. We came in. His wake up is completely priceless. His accent, first of all, his house is everything you want from Craig.
Is it?
Everything is glitterball.
Yeah.
There's a glitterball person that stands in the hallway. There's a glitterball dog on the way up the stairs. All the light fittings are full of feathers. I mean, fire hazards, but beautiful. And then Craig, he just sort of shakes. That goes on for a while. And then we shot him with a snow cannon. I couldn't think of anything more Christmassy to do. So that was followed up by another one. But he was brilliant. He actually loved it.
Did
as much as Rob Rinder, who's now taking legal action. He's perfectly entitled and qualified to do so. And then I also woke up all of Westlife, who were staying at a hotel in London.
Were they all in one room? Well, they had a sleepover?
All in one bed, like clarified. Seven dwarfs.
They were actually in adjacent rooms in a hotel.
Oh.
So I just woke them up one by one. And yes, and they're all so different, all the wake-ups. But there is, you'll have to watch it, one of them who goes for the classic Holly Willoughby bottom in the air scenario.
Can we not describe it as the classic? That's not a thing.
A bit of blurring.
So are they all told by their partners, someone?
Yeah.
I know you don't normally sleep with your pants on, but please put
your
pants
on. Oh, yes, no, we find out how they sleep and there is a pants thing. But sometimes you can't force someone to put pants on.
Of course you can.
It's a bit weird. And it's not the most romantic thing to say in couples, to say, darling, tonight I'd like you to sleep with your pants on if you've been sleeping with your pants off for 20 years of a lovely relationship. Do you know what? I've had enough of this naked stuff.
Well, how do you get around that?
It's a bit queasy.
Could you
put on a onesie tonight? Yes, but they do. They manage to do it. And also, you know, with contact lenses and glasses, some people can't. Oh, and there was one, yes, whose teeth was out. That was awkward. I woke up the lady in rollers. But, you know, it is what it is, and people have loved it. And I think that's why we've made it celebrity.
Yeah.
And also, it's funny with celebs, because they're show business. So they go through that whole, what on earth is happening? And then they realise, oh, right,
turn it on,
this is on
turn
TV.
It on.
Yeah. This is a big show.
Ping.
And then they're just suddenly like, hey, what's question number one? Even though they look terrible, they give it their absolute all. Craig was, like, really going for it. But it was excellent. They've all been wonderful, and they're just hilarious.
There's a new game as well in the audience which involves people's glasses.
Oh, well, we did this once. It was a silly game. It's more of a... It was a surprise on someone.
Right, OK.
It was actually a very sweet and romantic thing, ultimately. But it was just a very silly game called See It, Win It, where if you see what's on the stage, you win it. It's easy as that.
Sounds easy.
Except everybody who was playing the game were glasses wearers and they had to take their glasses off. And we sat them with worse and worse prescriptions the closer to the stage. So we had this woman in the front row, and literally, she was just right there. She had no idea what was going on. But it was the culmination for a surprise whereby this lady's boyfriend came out on bended knee and he was on a conveyor belt and the whole audience could see what was happening, but she had no idea because her glasses were off. And everyone's going, oh, and she's there going, is it a dog? Is it a dog? And she had no idea who it was.
That's amazing.
Until she got all the way to the stage and he proposed. And I have to say, we've done a lot of amazing, heartwarming things as well as very silly things. On our Christmas show, I mean, I hate to give too much away, but I did a thing with the Centre Wall phone after. I did Centre Wall with Sharon Osbourne. Mm. And then I just said to the audience, would anyone else like to plug their phone? Because, you know, I plug, well, you've played it.
Yeah.
Plug their phone. And you respond every week because you're in everyone's phone.
So I always know when you're actually making the show because I'm going to be sitting there watching the telly and something comes to me. Oh, Michael's
you're all over
working, yes.
So I got someone from the audience to plug their phone into it and I said, let's FaceTime a relative because it's Christmas. So I found someone with the furthest relative from the furthest, far, far away in New Zealand. They hadn't seen their son for 8 years and never met their grandchildren. And they popped up, sure enough, on the phone. And they were chatting, it was very sweet. And then during the conversation, the curtain went up and we'd recreated their whole living room from New Zealand. We'd flown everything over.
Oh.
And they were actually just there behind.
And they were there.
And the
so
shot
lovely.
Of them on the screen and then behind. Yeah. And it was just so...
Oh, my God, amazing.
So, well, you know about all this kind of thing.
Surprise, I know. It's a lovely thing to be able to do, though.
It was crazy. And it was very sweet and very, very Christmassy.
Well, we gave away £500,000 on here the other day, and that was the best thing ever,
was to
phone a competition winner up and say, actually, and she'd had a terrible week. Yeah. And then you can say, we're going to give you £500,000.
It's incredible to be able to do these things and to have these ideas. And when they, having said that, ultimately, a little bit of a waste of money to fly everything from the living room over, because we didn't realise that on FaceTime, you could literally only see the corner.
Wait, it was the real stuff?
Yes, we got all the pictures on the walls and the crockery.
Oh, my God.
We wanted to look authentic.
Attention for details.
What about the karaoke? Are you doing some...
Last couple of years, we've done this thing where we secretly film people singing karaoke and they sing it with the person. So we did... Kylie Minogue and Gary Oki with Gary Barlow. So actually, on the first show, we have Abba Oki, and we have Bjorn actually comes to the theatre.
I mean, that's incredible. And, they never do anything. Yeah.
And he judges their performances, and it's just him.
Ordering a drink.
Off a lager.
Oh, you've got to love that. Midway through the song.
And it was so funny, because then you've got Bjorn. I'm chatting to Bjorn about, you know, whether people are entitled to add drink orders in the middle of his lyrics. He took it very seriously. It was actually an amazing character. And we've got Robbie Williams doing it later in the series, Robbie Oki. Which is a lot more laddie, but Robbie was sensational. Wow. So yeah, we've got all sorts of things.
Just love it.
It's a lot of fun.
Are you still on tour? You've been touring forever. Are you still?
Yes, rather
than
having different tours, I've just said
just
the big
continue
tour.
The whole thing.
Just keep putting dates on. Yeah, it's been going on about 3 years, 4 years. It's the big world tour. I've nearly finished the world. I've just got America to do. I'm doing some American.
Yeah,
that's the biggest one.
I've started it's quite
with,
a big bit.
I'm ending with the biggest one.
So you've got time off at Christmas.
Time off at Christmas, yeah. Time off to get Christmassy. It's come along. It's quick, isn't it? It's fast. I feel like I was just here last year.
I know, talking about the last Christmas show. I know.
Yeah.
Quick. Not long to go.
It's come along real quick. But yes, time off at Christmas, then back on it. But so pleased with the way the show's gone.
Good.
And
nice,
it's so
brilliant.
Much fun. And we just love making it. We hope people enjoy it.
And it starts this Saturday, isn't it? 8:10, BBC One, Michael McIntyre's
8:10 till 9:10. That goes past the watershed.
Watershed. So
very saucy. Get the kids down after 50 minutes, I'm telling you. All hell breaks loose.
Michael, thank you.
Thank you very much.